Welcome back to our fourth video in Terra's educational series on critical environments. I'm Lindy, a Terra representative.
And I'm Evan, Director of Business Development at Terra. In this video, we'll discuss methods to protect your cleanroom from contamination.
First, let's define cleanroom contamination. A contaminant is any particle, viable or non-viable, that compromises the integrity of the cleanroom's cleanliness.
Although maintaining a contaminant-free cleanroom isn't realistic, recognizing potential sources of contamination is of utmost importance. 80% of contamination comes from one source, the personnel working in the cleanroom. The other five common sources are equipment, products, the facility, fluids, and processes.
Let's examine each contamination source in more detail, starting with personnel.
Since people are the primary contributors to cleanroom contamination, each employee must be mindful of three common sources: outside personal items, poor hygiene, and improper cleanroom attire.
Personal items that are common in a workplace setting, like food and drinks, must not enter the cleanroom. If operators must bring their keys, wallets, and cell phones into the cleanroom, employees should ensure they remain concealed under appropriate cleanroom garments. Many gowning spaces include high security lockers to store personal items while employees are working in the cleanroom.
Human hygiene is a particular threat to cleanroom cleanliness, given the microbiome on an individual's skin, hair, and nails. Before entering the cleanroom, each employee must thoroughly wash their hands for at least 20 seconds and remove perfume, cologne, nail polish, and cosmetics.
The final step to mitigate personnel-borne cleanroom contamination is proper gowning technique. For more information on gowning procedures and appropriate cleanroom attire, please follow the link on the screen to view Terra's educational video.
To summarize, employees must wear proper garments that comply with their cleanroom's ISO rating. This may include gloves, coveralls, face masks, shoe covers, bouffants, and hoods. When donning cleanroom attire, employees should dress from top to bottom, starting at their head and working down to their feet. As an extra precaution, many protocols require employees to pass through an air shower immediately prior to entering the cleanroom.
An often overlooked source of cleanroom contamination is non-compliant equipment. Selecting and installing the proper equipment that meets or exceeds the cleanroom ISO level is crucial to prevent contamination.
Non-compliant equipment may generate contaminants through vibration or may harbor microbes in cracks, crevices, or hard-to-clean areas. If the equipment isn't made of ISO-rated material, the surfaces may emit VOCs, shed particles during wipe-downs, or corrode after contact with acids or solvents.
To ensure their equipment complies with the proper ISO rating, many customers outfit their cleanrooms with Terra's BioSafe products. The BioSafe product line is designed to meet the most rigorous demands of not only the biomedical industry, but the semiconductor, aerospace, and pharmaceutical industries as well.
Terra's BioSafe products are manufactured to meet ISO 5 or in some cases ISO 4 standards, featuring rounded corners, continuous seam welds, smooth surfaces, non-shedding hardware, and composed of cleanroom-resistant material. Terra's BioSafe products carry a lower bioburden than conventional cleanroom equipment.
Cleanroom equipment manufacturers face a serious challenge when designing ISO-rated products: avoiding inaccessible compartments where dust, debris, and contaminants collect. Since these cubbyholes are impossible to clean, they act as incubators for microbial growth. Although this equipment may appear clean on the surface, the contaminants emanating from these slots will heavily affect your cleanroom cleanliness.
Terra has solved this industry-wide challenge with the new BioSafe design. Using high-precision, automated fabrication machinery, Terra manufactures ISO-rated BioSafe products that feature welded joints, easy-to-clean surfaces, and removable tops to wipe away dust collecting underneath. The BioSafe design completely eliminates slots, crevices, cubbyholes, and compartments that can't be accessed or cleaned.
Be wary of cleanroom equipment that contains unfiltered exhaust systems such as refrigerators, freezers, incubators, ovens, process machinery, or analytical instrumentation.
This equipment must be vented outside the cleanroom or installed in a barrier wall with the exhaust system directing air into an unrated adjacent space.
Other common sources of clean room contamination are non-compliant products and supplies, such as notebooks, sticky notes, pens, mouse pads, and name badge holders.
Since office supplies frequently come into contact with bare hands or soiled gloves, they often carry microbial contaminants. Be sure to equip your clean room with ISO-compliant clipboards, file holders, notebook paper, and non-woven polyester wipes.
The facility itself, if improperly designed and maintained, is a subtle yet harmful source of clean room contamination. In order to mitigate contamination, your clean room must maintain optimal environmental conditions and produce laminar airflow that sweeps particles away from work zones.
To limit bacterial growth, corrosion, and static electricity, the clean room should maintain an air temperature of 70 degrees Fahrenheit with a relative humidity level between 30% and 40%. These conditions are ideal for employee comfort, which has an effect on clean room cleanliness. As employees shiver, sweat, or move unnecessarily, they are prone to release particles into the environment.
A clean room that maintains uniform, unidirectional, HEPA-filtered airflow will limit the possibility of widespread product or sample contamination.
Laminar airflow prevents contamination caused by second-pass air or the particle swirling effect and ensures that the cleanest, filtered air washes across the most critical work areas.
Fluids, such as chemicals, solvents, reagents, and DI water, produce a breeding ground for bacterial growth. All liquids must be stored in closed cleanroom-compliant containers to inhibit microbial colonization.
Equipment with integrated fluid basins, such as water baths, circulators, water jacketed incubators, and wet stations, must be drained and cleaned daily to prevent bacterial buildup.
The final major cleanroom contamination source is improper cleaning and maintenance protocols. Your cleanroom should have clear posted guidelines on rigorous daily, weekly, and monthly cleaning procedures.
Beyond sanitizing work areas, the cleanroom procedure should include additional steps like mopping floors, vacuuming walls and corners, and using sticky rollers to remove loose particles from surfaces. Always clean from the top of the cleanroom to the bottom, starting with the ceilings and working down to the walls, tables, and floors. This approach ensures that all contaminants fall to the floor, where they're collected and easily removed.
Enforcing a strict maintenance schedule will limit the possibility of contamination stemming from outdated parts, especially saturated filters.
The maintenance schedule should account for regular replacement of air filters installed in FFUs, pass-throughs, hoods, biosafety cabinets, and vacuum cleaners, as well as inline filters installed in water purity systems.
Before we end our discussion, let's go over a few tips and tricks to protect your clean room from contamination.
For germicidal disinfection of supplies that are common contamination sources, Terra offers the UV sanitizing cabinet for safety goggles, the Clean Slate UV for mobile devices, the UVP cross linker for face masks, the back to zapper for pipettes and inoculating loops, the healthy sole for shoe covers and booties, and the handy box for gloves.
When working in the clean room, move slowly and deliberately. Fast motion stirs up particles from clothing and releases contaminants into the air.
Avoid touching multiple work surfaces or products with the same pair of gloves. After each task is complete, change out your gloves to prevent particles from migrating between work areas.
Consistently monitor your clean room's cleanliness to ensure that your required ISO rating is maintained.
Use a handheld airborne particle counter to take daily or weekly measurements of your work zones, high traffic spaces, and gowning areas. To monitor bacterial growth in the clean room, use an automated GMP-compliant microbial air sampler.
Thanks for spending time with us today as we discussed cleanroom contamination.
For more information, please visit Terra's website at terrauniversal.com or call 714-578-6100 to speak with one of Terra's cleanroom specialists.